أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، أيا من ليس لي منه مجير، بعفوك من عذابك أستجير. أنا العبد المقر من كل ذنب، وأنت يا سيد المولى الغفور. فإن عذبتني فبسوء فعلي، وإن تغفر لي فأنت منه جدير. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا صلى الله عليه وسلم كل القلوب إلى الحبيب تميل، ومعي بهذا شاهد ودليل. أما الدليل إذا ذكرت محمدًا صارت دموع العاشقين تسيل. هذا رسول الله نبراس الهدى، هذا لكل العالمين رسول، صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله عز وجل، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. إخوة الإيمان، أحباب وأتباع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, after praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending blessings and salutations to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. إخواني, most of us we know that every a'mal in Islam that we're doing, it was made wajib to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam while Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam he was on the earth. About one thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him compulsory while he was to the heavens near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is the salah ibadallah. And him, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that salah was made to him qurrata ayni, was made comfortable of his eyes to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. With the salah ibadallah, as Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he mentioned that there is one rukn of the salah, there is one pillar of the salah, and this pillar of the salah, it is the most important pillar of among all the pillars of the salah. And this pillar, to make it important, you will see that each pillar of the salah, each arkan of the salah, may it be a sunnah or anything, you will do once and once. But this one, in each rakah, you do twice. And your rakah will not be completed if you do only once. To give you an example, in the salah, when you read, when you stand only once. When you make ruku only once. When you read Surah Al-Fatiha in that one rakah, you read only once. When you make i'tidal from the ruku, you stand only once. But when you prostrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you make sujood, you make twice sujood. Ibadallah. And it's showing in this that how this sujood, it is important, ibadallah. So in today's khutbah, inshallah, we will talk. The importance of making sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And making sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is not only human beings who are prostrating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not only human beings, even all other creatures that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, they're making sujood, they're making prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May it be the angels, may it be other creation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَسْجُدُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Don't you see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prostrate to him wherever it is on the heavens and wherever it is on the earth. وَالشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ وَالنُّجُومُ. Even the sun is prostrating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even the moon, it is prostrating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even the stars. making prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even wal-jibal wal-shajar wal-dawab. Even the trees, look how the trees, some of the trees, how strong are these trees. But they're making sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The jibal, look on the rocks and the mountains, how big they are. They're making sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And even وَكَثِيرٌ مِّنَ النَّاسِ. Even many people, they're making prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان الشمس والقمر بحسبان والنجم والشجر يسجدان والنجم والشجر يسجدان. The stars and the trees are making sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of these things, they're making sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what is the virtues and the importance of you making sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is Rabi' ibn al-Ka'b al-Aslami. He was with Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Sahih Muslim. Rabi' ibn al-Ka'b, he says, كنت عديت مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I was sleeping with Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the house of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one of the night. فأتيته بوضوئه وحاجته. I brought to him Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the water that he will need for his wudu and any other things that he will need. And then Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to me, Sal, ask me anything, I will give it to you. So Rabi' ibn al-Ka'b, he started thinking and thinking, and he knew that anything in this dunya, it will be fine here. He will live for it. So while he was thinking, he came across and he said to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulallah, as'aluka murafaqataka fil jannah. Ya Rasulallah, I want your company. Ya Rasulallah, I want to be with you in the jannah. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, Awa ghayra dhalik? You don't want anything apart from this? And he said, Rabi' said to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Dhaka ya Rasulallah. This is the only thing that I want, ya Rasulallah. And listen what Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to Rabi' ibn Ka'b, Rabi'a ibn Ka'b, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to Rabi'a ibn Ka'b, A'inni ala nafsika bi kathrati sujood. Help me, for me to help you, for you making more sujood. For you making more prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So from this hadith, it is clear that, and it sure makes you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more they make you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will be closer to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Is there any place in the Jannah when you're closer to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ikhwani? And Thawban, he narrates that Mawla Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Mi'dan asked Thawban, tell me, al-a'mal yudkhilun al-jannah, tell me a deed that it will take me to the Jannah. And Thawban, Mawla Rasulullah, the slave of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he became quiet. And he asked again, and he asked again, and then finally, Thawban, he said to Mi'dan that, I asked Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the same question. I asked Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, show me or tell me a amal that it will take me to the Jannah. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to me that, make more sujood. Make more sujood. Make more prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِنَّكَ لَا تَسْجُدُ لِلَّهِ سَجْدَةً. For you will not make any sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala إِلَّا رَفَعَكَ اللَّهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase in your degree in the Jannah. He will elevate you in the Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala وَحُطَّ عَنْكَ الْقَطِيئَةُ وَحَطَّ عَنْكَ الْقَطِيئَةُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will wipe your sins. For you making prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your degree in the Jannah will be higher and higher. And your sins will be white and white. Will be white. And when you make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hadith that narrated by Abu Hurairah in Sahih Muslim, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, أقرب ما يكون العبد من ربه وهو ساجد. The closest and the nearest a slave of Allah will be with his Lord, it is when he is in his sujood, when he is prostrating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the time that dua ibad Allah. This is the word of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He says, فَقَلِنُ أَن يُسْتَجَابَ لَكُمْ. It will be worthy for you to be accepted that dua. If you make any sins, make prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will easily forgive you and will easily reply to your dua. If you want anything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just make prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer you. Whatever you want in this dunya, make prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer whatever you want, and it will be easy, as Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. And look, ibadallah, for shaitan, him rejecting one sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّ عَلَيْكَ اللَّعْنَةِ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ. And you, Iblis, you will have my la'na, my curse, until the day of judgment. And the curse and the la'na of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling shaitan to go away from the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And look to those people who believed in the Musa, those magicians of the time of Fir'aun, on the time of Musa alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأُلْقِيَ السَّحَرَةُ سُجَّدًا. The magicians, they prostrated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the morning, in the beginning of the day, as Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he says that in the beginning of the day, they are kafir, and in the end of the day, they were in the Jannah. For them believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and for them making sujood, this was the first a'mal that this magician of the time of Musa alayhi salam, they've done, was them prostrating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took them to the Jannah al-Firdaus. Ibadallah, in the day of judgment, on the day of judgment, when the people will be alert from the ummah, from the beginning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created from the Adam, and from the last people, all of them, they will be in one place, ibadallah. And there will be only one hope, and there will be only one river. And this is the river of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you are loyal, that you are closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is no pleasure in this dunya. The only pleasure in this dunya, it is when you are closer to your Lord, when you are closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his final death, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he opened the curtains. When he opened the curtains, he saw Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu leading the salah. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he started delivering a sermon to the Muslim. And he told the Muslim that, he said the final thing that he said that, listen what Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, in the ruku' fa'adhimu rabba. In the ruku' make ta'zim of the rug, say subhana rabbi al-a'la, subhana rabbi al-azim. But in the sujood, he says make dua as much as you like. Then Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says faqaminun an yustajaba lakum. It is worthy for your du'as to be accepted so quickly and so easily. You make prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In that time, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala anything. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala anything in your sujood. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will easily reply to that dua. Will easily answer. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that anyone who believed in me, they will come and drink from that hawl. And the Sahaba, they asked Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, on that day the people will be alert. How are you going to know Ya Ummah? And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, I'm going to know them in two ways. In Sahih Ahmad, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, I will know them from the athar al-sujood, from the marks of the sujood. And in another narration, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he says, you will know them from the wudu that they make. Ibad Allah. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he will realize that you are among his ummah by only two things, by the wudu that you make, and also by the sujood that you prostrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You prostrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the only thing that it was written in the Torah. It was written in the Zabur. And it was written in the Quran. That Ummah Muhammad will be known by the marks of the sujood. Listen what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. Muhammadun Rasulullah. والذين معه أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم تراهم ركعا سجدا يبتغون فضلا من الله ورضوانا سيماهم في وجوههم من أثر السجود on their faces there is a marks of the sujood ذلك مثلهم في التوراة ومثلهم في الإنجيل it is exactly how it was written in the Torah and it is exactly it was written in the Injil It is written in the Injil and the Torah that Ummah Muhammad, the sign will be on the sujood, on the faces. But Allah, even if people of some of us, they will go to the hellfire, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make among them. If anyone who believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they believe in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take them away from the hellfire. But those people who will go to the hellfire, as Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, وَإِنَّ النَّارَ لَا تَأْكُلُ آثَارُ السُّجُودِ The hellfire will not eat the place, the mat that makes sujood. The hellfire will eat all of you, but it will not eat the place that makes sujood, ibadallah. You are still in the hellfire, You're still in the hellfire, but this place that makes the prostrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not eat the hellfire, ibadallah. So it is important for us to make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praise Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أَمَّنْ هُوَ قَانِتٌ آنَاءَ اللَّيْلِ سَاجِدًا وَقَائِمًا يَحْضَرُ الْآخِرَةِ He praised Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that He was making sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was prostrating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most of the time. And in the beginning of the revelations, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الَّذِي خَلَقْ خَلَقَ الَّذِي مِنْ اِقْرَ بِاسْمِ رَبِّكَ الَّذِي خَلَقْ To the end of the surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَصَلِّ وَاسْجُدْ وَاقْتَرِبْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, make prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you will be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibadallah, most of us, we say we make prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we don't know the ahkam of how to make prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Most of us, we think that we're doing it in a right way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Suratul Kahf, قُلْ هَلْ أُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا Shall I not tell you those who are losers in whatever أعمال that are doing? الَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعْيُهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا Those who went wrong in whatever they're doing. وَهُمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ صُنْعًا And they thought that whatever they're doing, it is alright. So عباد الله, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he says, أمرت أن أسجد على سبع وفي رواية أمرت أن أسجد على سبعة أعظم I was commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make sujood onto seven parts of the body عباد الله Some of us when we make prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we don't use the commandment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to make prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will see some of us when we make in prostration, we lift in our hands, we lift in our legs, we lift in our knees, we lift in our faces, and this is not the right way how to make prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibadallah. How It is the right way to make prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned these seven parts of the body. And these seven parts of the body, ibadallah, it is the forehead and the nose, al-jabha, ibadallah. And also the palm hand. Some of us, we make a prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we lift in our palm hands. And this is not the right way, ibadallah. And wal rukbatan, and the two knees. You don't have to lift your two knees, ibadallah. And also, your toes. Some of us, when you're making prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you're making prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we lift in our toes. And when you lift your toes, you might be thinking, Lord, you're doing in a right way, ibadallah. But your a'mal will be nullified. Your a'mal will be nothing. And in the day of judgment of those munafiqeen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَوْمَ يُكْشَفُ عَنْ سَاقٍ وَيُدْعَوْنَ إِلَى السُّجُودِ فَلَا يَسْتَطِعُونَ. On the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell them, okay, now make prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَلَا يَسْتَطِعُونَ. They will be unable to do it, prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. Because why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them in the dunya to make prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُمْ سَالِئُونَ. While they have their wealth, while they have their health, while they have everything, while they have so peaceful, but they were not prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or their prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or they making prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but forcing themselves. Ibadallah, there's a people who are making prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they forcing themselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, وَلِلَّهِ يَسْجُدُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ طَوْعًا وَكَرْهًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prostrates to him those people who are on the heavens and those people who are on the earth, طَوْعًا وَكَرْهًا. Those people who obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and prostrate Allah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way he wants. And there's others who prostrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala karhan or kurhan, by them forcing themselves. They forcing themselves. That's why you see them when ta'ala, they lifting their hands, they lifting their legs, even their mind, it is not connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned in his hadith, he says, a man, he was asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he was saying, Ya Rabbi, Ya Rabbi, وَمَطْعَمُهُ حَرَامُ وَمَلْبَسُهُ حَرَامُ وَقُضِيَ بِالْحَرَامُ فَأَنَّا يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ. A person was asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, using every ways to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, raising his hands to the sky. And he was saying the word of Ya Rab, Ya Rab, O Allah, O Allah. But he was eating haram, he was drinking haram, he grew up in a haram way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَأَنَّا يُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ. How are we going to accept his dua? It is exactly when you're not using the right way to prostrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer your dua? How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your salah, ibadallah, to ibadallah.